We are a generation who loves God. We are a generation who trusts in God. We will always hope in God. Welcome, 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 my dear friend, to another video brought to you by GFM United Prayer and Revival Ministry Studios. It's Evangelist Gabriel Fernandes here, and I am so happy to be with you. It is another day that God has given us, another day to live to the fullest, and each and every day that we get is a gift. We should appreciate each and every day that we have to live on and to make our mark in this realm. My dear friend, I want to speak to you today, and the title of my message is Wind in Your Sails. Say that with me. Say, wind in my sails. Hallelujah. Let us begin by welcoming the Holy Spirit. Wherever you are, in your own words, welcome the Holy Spirit in the place where you're watching. Precious Holy Spirit of God, we welcome you. Come, Lord Holy Spirit, and bless us. Help us to pray, help us to press in, and help us to receive from the Father even today. Take us to a greater level and a greater glory. Take us closer to Jesus. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear friend, in order for us to keep on going, we need the strength and the wind of God in our sails. We need the divine empowerment that comes from God through the power of the Holy Spirit in Christ Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8, you will receive power after that the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses. So there is a power and a divine enablement to fulfill the calling that God has given us. And when I speak about wind in our sails, this is what I refer to. Sometimes we need to sit and wait on God in order to receive the strength and the boost that we need in order to go on. In the year of 2024, I encourage you, spend a lot of time soaking and waiting in the presence of God, resting in God's presence and receiving, because God wants to bless you. God wants to take you to greater glories and a greater level. And He loves you. He loves you with an everlasting love. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, from verse 31, it says, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. In some translations, it says, wait, those who wait on the Lord. It's important that through faith, we hope and wait on God. We trust Him with everything that concerns our lives. Being born again, born of water and of spirit. We are in this world, but we are not of this world. Therefore, we do not do things like they do them in the world. We do not do things the same way as the world. We have a different way of doing things. It says, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. As you wait on God, God will renew your strength. As you hope in God, God will renew your strength. It goes on and says, they will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Now, when you look at an eagle, it is a magnificent bird. And it's something that's delightful to look at. As you see an eagle passing, it's not the same as just seeing any other bird. It's special. It's a special moment. There is a degree of respect it commands as it soars through the sky. And we notice that is an eagle. Now the Bible says, but those who hope or wait in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. I love that it uses this example here in the scripture, because it shows how, when you hope and wait in God, how you will soar in life, how you will fly. People will look at you and they will be amazed, because God will give you grace to succeed and to prosper. They will run and not grow weary. So they will run, they will push forward with speed and not become discouraged. They will walk and not be faint. So they will keep on pushing forward, and they will not become tired, because their source of strength is from God. In the year 2024, I encourage you, spend time with God. Spend time soaking in His presence. Spend time waiting on God. Put your hope and your trust in God as a born-again believer, and you will never be disappointed. Those who trust in God are never disappointed, and God is with them. When we hope in our Lord, our strength is renewed. Hoping and trusting in the Lord is the best thing we can do, especially in times when it seems difficult. But don't only wait for the difficult times to start waiting on God or to spend time in His presence. The best time and the most important time to pray is when everything is going well. Don't wait for the hard times to come before you start to pray, before you start to spend time with God. Pray in advance, so that when hard times come, you will find that your prayers have gone ahead of you and they've cleared the way. Pray in advance. I like to make a statement and say, fill up the prayer bank account. Fill up your prayer bank account and pray ahead that God will go before you and fight the battles. In saying that, let us go into a time of prayer. Let us begin to praise God just for a few moments, and then we'll begin to pray. I'll pray for you in line with this word, and I know God will bless you. Father, we praise you and we thank you. Thank you for another day. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. And thank you that you don't leave us helpless. You're with us, speaking to us, guiding us, and showing us the way. The way that leads to life, and life in abundance. We give you praise and we thank you that it is not the end until you say it's the end. Thank you for our family and friends that you've placed around us. And thank you for the grace that you've afforded to us, the anointing that you've entrusted to us. Thank you, Lord, for your presence and for being with us. Lead us and guide us, O Lord, in the way that we must go. Lead us and guide us to life and life in abundance. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear friend, I discern God's presence, and I know God will bless you. Be expectant for a miracle, even as I pray for you. Comment and agree, connect in faith, and believe God for a miracle. In saying that, let us begin. Father, I pray for my dear friend. As my dear friend who is watching this video, my dear friend, your dear son, my dear friend, your dear daughter, as they are watching this video and they have connected in faith, let strength arise as they put their hope and their trust in you. Let strength arise. Let strength rise as we wait on you. Give my dear friends strength to conquer all battles and all challenges ahead of them. Give my dear friends strength to seek you and to spend time in your presence. Give my dear friend a hunger and a desire for more of you, for more of your presence, that my dear friend will enjoy times in your presence like never before. Bless my dear friend mightily, 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 and take my dear friend to a greater level and a greater realm, even in the year of 2024. Open doors of blessing, doors of favor, doors of opportunities. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for watching. If you were blessed by this video and you would like to support us to keep making content like this, you can do so via PayPal or Patreon. The links are provided in the description. God bless you and goodbye.